If you look at it from the North Korean perspective, they have always believed that nuclear weapons would be the key to peace and stability in this region by preventing the United States from, in their view, bullying them. They feel if they can prove they have an effective nuclear deterrent, then perhaps the U.S. will try to talk instead of trying to impose sanctions and making military threats. But the real fear and the growing fear is that if North Korea actually goes through with this kind of a nuclear test, which does seem increasingly likely, the results and the response from the United States, unknown. Flying into the North Korean capital, life on the surface seems normal. Beneath the surface, it's anything but. Overseas North Korean workers are being sent home in droves, their jobs eliminated by UN sanctions. The U.S. calls it punishment for an illegal, dangerous nuclear program. North Korea calls it evil, an economic blockade. On my 16th trip to Pyongyang, I still see signs of growth, plenty of traffic, construction, a steady flow of electricity, keeping the growing skyline bright. But the prospects of a peaceful resolution to the nuclear standoff with the U.S. seem to be growing darker by the day. At North Korea's Ministry of Foreign Affairs,
Mr. Reed, thank you so much.
We asked to meet with a senior diplomat. Lee Yong-pil agrees to talk, but the mood is tense. His anger at the U.S. palpable.
Donald Trump said he would totally destroy North Korea, a sovereign state.
He's referring to the U.S. president's fiery speech at the U.N. last month when he personally insulted a fellow head of state.
Rocket Man is on a suicide mission for himself and for his regime.
North Korean leader Kim Jong-un fired back, calling President Trump's behavior mentally deranged. North Korea's foreign minister made a threat that alarmed even longtime Korea watchers.
This could probably mean the strongest hydrogen bomb test over the Pacific Ocean.
Some analysts have accused North Korea of bluster, saying they haven't yet achieved full nuclear capability. And if they go to war, they risk total destruction. But the North Koreans warn the U.S. not to underestimate their resolve and their growing arsenal.
Should the world prepare for North Korea to detonate a nuclear device above ground?
The foreign minister is very well aware of the intentions of our supreme leader, so I think you should take his words literally.
U.S. and North Korean officials tell CNN diplomacy has broken down, pushing two nuclear powers dangerously close to military conflict.
The U.S. is talking about a military option and even practicing military moves. They're pressuring us on all fronts with sanctions. If you think this will lead to diplomacy, you're deeply mistaken.
So then I ask, what needs to happen for diplomacy to resume?
The U.S. needs to understand our new strategic power and fundamentally eliminate its hostile policy towards the DPRK.
He says North Korea's leader is following through on a pledge to reach a nuclear balance of power with the U.S., which they say will lead to peace and stability. Even as many around the world worry, the end result could be the exact opposite.
If North Korea were to go through with this atmospheric thermonuclear test, it would be the first the world has seen in nearly four decades since China did it back in 1980. But again, North Korean officials here reiterated this would only be a test to improve their technical knowledge, to send a message that they have this nuclear deterrent. They would not consider this an act of war. Again, in their view, nuclear weapons will guarantee peace, a view counterintuitive to much of the rest of the world who really worry what is going to happen. And then, of course, Michael and Amber, the big question here, timing with President Trump's visit to Asia happening in less than 2 weeks.